Bernard, second cadet of the Queen's Men, is giving a tribute to his late father, the noble Nicholas, most revered of the Queen's Men. Now come along. We don't want to be late.
Give us your card, Olivia.
Before dessert, my children and I must keep this card in the inn. We plan to sell what we can to the villagers.
We do not negotiate.
It looks like we'll have to take this one by force.
Thank you.
his dear father.
A tribute to noble Nicholas, most revered of the Queen's men. A more stalwart fellow there never was, valiant to the end. His was the purest heart of all, defender of his friends. With a bravery as bold as the red of the sunset, he fought in favor of the Queen. 'Twas this loyalty that sealed the truth forever, that no Queen's man so noble will ever be seen. Our progenies for generations to come will tell all by both tongue and pen that the most trusty man there ever was noble Nicholas, most revered of the Queen's men.
Thank you.
by this?
I've heard it said that some believe that your father was the lead conspirator for the bloody death of the king. Had a disagreement with the other three conspirators, which led to his demise.
You mean to tell me that my father, Noble Nicholas, most revered in the queen's men, actually died a traitor, and you believe this awful rumor?
No, sir. I know. That's why I thought I should tell you. Someone needs to make things right.
Who started this rumor?
I do not know. I only know that it's spreading.
Get out of my sight, bearing such lies about my poor deceased father. I will not speak to you of this any longer.
Thank you.
you forgot?
Yes, if you happen to try thinking every once in a while, you would know that some thoughts can override others.
If I happen to try thinking, my mind would be a gifted orator.
I'm sorry. I did. I truly am.
I hope you are sorry. I waited down in that meadow until I felt chilled, and then I wandered all over the woods looking for you. And finally, I ran into some old peasant woman who said she saw you hurrying through the village square this afternoon with the woman with the bushy eyebrows.
You are her foe?
What? No, I do not think I've ever even seen her. It's just the way the peasant woman described her to me.
Is she her foe?
Bear not! Why are you acting so defensive? I do not think that frail old woman could be a foe to anyone. What is wrong with you?
That woman you speak of is acting as a great friend to me, and the thought of anyone being her foe angers my heart.
Bernard, are you angry with me? I did not mean to seem suspicious. You are the suspicious one. What is going on?
I wish to not speak to you about it. Not until I know things are right. To talk to you about it now would only make a terrible situation worse.
Bernard, if you want to keep meeting me in the meadow, you must tell me what is going on.
Then I suppose I am not meeting you in the meadow anymore.
And I suppose I will not keep meeting you in the meadow either, Bernard.
Ah! one of the Queen's men that you took an oath to the king above your own, and honestly, always in a dictated by the king, for the support of the Queen's men and demonstrated truth and honor upon one of the
When the Queen's men took their oath, they lived it seriously. Noble Nicholas kept the oath to the letter. There was never a Queen's man, before or after, with more valor. He was an inspiration to the men he served. Foxhorn, Rachel.
There were also a few women in that time who wished to pledge such loyalty to the Queen and country. They were experts in sword and fearless in battle. Sadly, their character was not pure. Hoping to use their skills to trample on the weakness of others and gain power, one fateful day they plotted against the Queen while hiding in a garden in a castle for any celebration. Popcorn and Jessica.
Before they could carry out their plan, Noble Nicholas discovered them. His shout brought the other Queen's men running. To their horror, Noble Nicholas had been slain by none other than Genevieve, Yvonne, and Alphonsine, the Honorable Three.
What?!
What awful people. They're my relatives. I would blame
them. Hey, Sam. Wasn't Alphonsine one of your relatives? Did he break your in-laws?
Yeah, so I would be so embarrassed if I was living with her. And why? Because who knows what feels bad to all these running family.
Excuse me?
Genevieve, Yvonne, and Alphonsine,
Stop talking.
And start walking!
My descendants, in chains! This is infuriating! I will find who is responsible for this and make him accountable for his actions!
How are we supposed to find out who started the lie to him? How are we supposed to get back to our own time?
We need to find that portal and hope it takes us where we need to go.
Something smells familiar.
Alphonsine, let's go!
False, but and must be set straight.
Martine?
The peasant came to me shortly after our last rendezvous with Elena. She told me that there had been a heinous lie circulating in the village, that my father had died as it had plotted against the queen and died a traitor. Martine happened to find me afterwards. She told me that she had also found a strange power to travel into the future, and she saw that the people there believed the lie. She told me that if I wrote a document disproving the lie, that it would make things right. And it hasn't. What am I to do?
I still don't understand who Martine is. Wait, Martine? Is that the woman with the bushy eyebrows?
Bernard! Come back here and face your fears! You
No, I decided to keep my oath as Queen's Man and defend the Queen and Country. Now let's go and make things right.
And Genevieve?
Yvonne?